Or U9.
U9.
U9, but there's like three U's. That's why I'm like, U9.
So you call them SCCC?
SCCC.
S-triple, okay.
S-triple, that's cool. I like that.
That's good.
Yeah.
Probably won't go for the Weaver this time around versus Terrorblade. It's not really the greatest one, like, matchup like that, but it's great versus bad.
Ooh, hero prediction. All right, versus Terrorblade, what do we like? Not a melee.
Not a melee.
Hmm. Against Batrider, you want a natural Lincoln's Carrier? Not
what if they just go Naga?
Naga? They could, but would they?
I don't think that they would.
We saw SC Naga, S triple C Naga the other day. It was awful.
And it's true.
So I would stay away from that for sure.
Was that because of the Naga or because of?
Oh no, it was because of SC.
Okay.
Oh, so that's, I mean, it's a melee hero, but
that hero's been pretty dead for a while.
Mm-hmm. There surely is a reason that he's been dead.
Yeah, he's bad.
There you go. So why would they pick him here?
Because they just wanted another hero with like AoE clearance for the Terrorblade illusions, but he's also a melee. I mean, if you can make sure that you're not going to get sundered, then it's good.
More burst, and they get some siege, at least from it. And IGV goes for Tinker.
Okay.
Tinker Terrorblade. It's as cancerous as it gets.
Pretty
no,
awkward.
I'm just kidding. It's not as bad as Alcor Naga, but I like IGV's draft this game. Yeah. I think they got a lot better route, and I don't think Sven is a hero. I don't feel like that hero should be on anybody's draft screen this tournament.
Harsh words, but I like them.
I mean, that's my opinion. Yeah. I could be wrong.
And you're entitled to it, opinion. Yep. That's why you're on the panel. That's why we love you for it. Shiva, let's start with predictions.
Yeah, I'd go for IGV as well.
Yeah?
Yeah, who am I to...
No.
It's opinion. It's your own opinion.
No, but I think the draft is really solid. I think that they can't keep people in the Monkey King ultimate very easily. They can't take towers that easily. I think they're going to have a really tough time dealing with going high ground. If they even get ahead, because that's all we're going to rely on that, getting ahead in the early game. Even if they do that, going high ground against Terrorblade Tinker, good luck. So IGV for me.
Couldn't have said it better myself. I agree with everything Shiva said.
So you're copying Shiva, Peter?
Everything Shiva said, I agree with.
How dare you copy other people?
And I will go with IGV. Vogt, say something genius.
I mean...
Save us, Vogt!
I don't really like the Sven. It's a BKB carrier, at least. I mean, I'll make a little difference. I'll go for newbie. I like the way that they played with the Abaddon earlier.
No,
I don't like Sven.
No one's forcing you to pick a team.
It's fine. I'm
just interested what Red Eye has to say. He was so right about the Terrorblade.
Well, we don't know, but it looks pretty good right now, doesn't it?
I think it's going to be a little bit hard for newbie, but I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt with the Abaddon just because of the way they performed with it earlier.
Okay. All right. Little bit of a split decision here. I got a feeling... Really, they're all on the same page here on the analyst panel. It's time to get into our second game of the day. Is this a 2-0 sweep, or are we going to have another game? We'll find out as we head back to our commentary team, Toby Wan.
Oh, that's a good question. Will it actually be 2-0? Ben, does Sven belong in the arena, or does he belong in the trash?
He belongs on the 7.05 patch notes, where he belongs.
Always looking to the future.
He is... easily kiteable. He's like, he was good with Helmet Dom, but now Helmet Dom's like not so great. I do like the Warcry versus the Terrorblade. That is quite nice, but I don't actually think you're that scared of the Terrorblade this game. You have the Lina. They don't have Venge to buff him up. They actually have no way to buff him up. There's no Amp. There's no Curse of Avernus even.
Nope.
There's no like Vlad's buyers. There's no Medallion buyers. Like,
maybe they're just thinking about that frontline tank, that one person that can stand there in the middle of Warcry and go, okay, just come at me, bro, and let Lina do the work.
That's actually true. He will gather a lot of attention, but normally you just like throw a sticky on him and then you forget about him because he can't deal with sticky. We'll see.
It does seem odd, but maybe the evil plan of newbie will all come to fruition very, very shortly. Jump in. Well, that's not going to work from Kaka. Paparazzi still gets the rune.
KP's also playing Abba, which will help Sven not get kited. I think without the Abba, Sven would just be absolutely horrendous. But I think with the Abba, it's actually playable in this matchup because you can kind of run in and not get scared. You don't have to like BKB a laser off, for example. You don't have to worry that much about the lasso. There's a lot of freedom that the Abba affords.
Man, we're just doing this
Dude,
again.
Paparazzi's
back in mid.
Like, you gotta get out of here, Nakata.
Tinker on SC.
hubris, perhaps. I mean, he did beat SEC last time, but...
What, you're saying this is the mind game, or just by popular demand in China
I think this
has to happen once more?
I mean, it might have gotten to him that he's like, now I'm the best mid in the world, I can't lose this lane, but you can still lose the game even though you are the best mid in the world. It's a team game, and you need to be able to transition out of this. What if you get pressured? What if ganks don't go your way? What if a bad rune goes against you? Like, there's so many things that are just way different in a real game with Dota as opposed to a regular 1v1.
KP's being rolled on, but while he's got that shield sitting safely underneath the tier 1 tower is something he's very able to do. Top lane in July also taking a lot of harassment. This Batrider would love to just pop down, but he knows that Kaka is just bouncing around, and he can spring himself down towards those camps. The second in July thinks about trying to farm it, and without the second level, it's not really something in July can actually think about.
Nor does he have any help going his way, because Earth Spirit is revealing on bottom. So that makes SEC's life easy. It makes Injuli's life really, really difficult.
Mm-hmm. And that allows Sven to be bigger, right? Mr. 7-for-6 CS-wise.
Oh, yeah, Sven also has CM aura, so he has a lot of things going his way. But at the same time, imagine if you had a good hero with Abba behind you and CM aura.
Yes.
It's not so bad here. I'm like, yeah, if they can actually stack up for him, I think it's pretty decent.
Another good thing is that it's going to be that flash farming you can get from the stacks.
Yep.
Something which SC is not really capable of doing if it's ancient stacks.
U9 has also been playing way better today than I've seen him during the group stage, let's say. They have definitely turned his game up.
I wonder if something's wrong when you look at the top rune and you see both the haste and a regeneration rune just sitting there. It's like, oh, I get. Do they add that to the new changelog?
Oh no, my god, two runes.
Kaka just walks straight past him. Like, okay, yep, cool. We'll just ignore him.
I think he wanted the fame placing award. I mean, why else would you walk there?
Yeah.
Potentially get right clicked by Tinker or to next level mind game them. It would have been cooler if he'd taunted.
They've got two observe wards. Paparazzi's actually got all the vision on the field. That one observe ward selected now just behind SC, and then the other one sitting just south of the Roshan. It's rather difficult. Okay, sentry, Kaka takes to the trees, and then goodbye. Interesting to see what he's trying to achieve. Like, if you're just wondering about where these observe wards are from IG, and Kaka hasn't found any of them. He committed two sentries. One's up on that top lane near the pull point. Oh, Paparazzi, so low SC. Oh, flashbacks to last night.
He has to go to the...
He has to shrine.
Yeah, he has a shrine right now. He doesn't know where Monkey King is, but I guess it's not that big a deal. Is Monkey King showing? Oh, yeah, Monkey King.
He's watching the bottom lane. Just, he's leeching is what he's doing. And then range creep wins.
Oh, Jingu. He actually hasn't skilled it up. It's a little surprising. He's already level 2. He could have potentially traded a little bit more with Sakata, but perhaps seeing if he needs the Boundless Strike to survive a potential gank.
Mm-hmm. Or potentially set up for one if he needs it to secure the kill.
Mm-hmm.
Now, everything is going pretty passive at the very start here. But it seems both teams are very happy with this. This is allowing Paparazzi to get some good farm. He's 17-7 against the 19-3. So it's a good matchup as opposed to most other mids who have tried to match up against the Lina. And July can't really do much.
He has level 1 flame break.
Okay, so maybe he could reposition SC and it will work. When Dogfights comes in, they're able to pick up the kick. And, well, Paparazzi lasers the victory for first blood in mid.
Paparazzi also already committed to 2 points in March, so it looks like he wants to get his farm on.
Bottom lane, a lot of support, about to jump in. Sakata getting hit by it, TP support is coming in, so Terrorblade, he wanted to be very aggressive with this push-up metamorphosis, it won't work, and Super also stunned up. SC, the rotation in, so they'll pick up both the Rubick and the Terrorblade. And that was SC just TPing out after his death in mid.
That's why you hold on to your points on Monkey King. He has 2 points in the Boundless Strike and actually did a lot of damage there, and it doubles the duration on the stun. That's definitely something to consider, as opposed to the early Jingu. So now Kaka, they want to set up on Paparazzi. Don't want him to get his BOTs too early. He's actually going for Soul Ring first. Better for farming camps.
All that vision from the mid lane is gone. like, no Observer Ward is watching Karka's movement at the moment, and in fact, Earth Spirit's coming up from behind, same with Faith. They need that initial stun. Faith will also need to get the Frostbite off, with Dogfights arriving, able to get a double kick onto Karka and SC, but the Frostbite is there. Paparazzi, he'll get a revenge kill, but it's the mid for a support.
That level 2 Boundless Strike, that extra half second stun actually helped him land that Light Strike away. A big victory for his skill choice. U9 already stacking up some camps. No signs of Helmut Dominator. I don't know what you actually get on Sven now, because I haven't seen Sven in a while, and Helmut Dominator has been nerfed. It used to be like, what, Helm, Echo, Blink, and then BKB if we needed to do more damage. But now, do you actually get Helm now? Perhaps, maybe not.
I think I saw it in his quick bite for a second. Paparazzi, there goes your jump again. Frostbite. SC doesn't really have enough burst damage for this just yet, but with the extra stun, the Light Strike array will connect. The silence from Dogfights comes way too late. The Fade Ball bouncing around, but with the pickup, you'd be dragging back Faith. Okay, maybe you're not dragging Faith back anywhere. Super in the battle, he doesn't want to have. SC will get the double kill. Karka's last little swing allowed that to happen. So another two heroes lost for IG in the mid lane, and Newbie off to a fantastic start.
And they're shutting down the Tinker. Tinker was doing pretty well, probably the best on the Radiant side, but after those two deaths, it's not been easy life. He also committed for early raindrop, because he's like, I don't want to die to Lina, I don't want to get bursted down, but raindrops aren't going to be enough. The same from these three hero ganks, and Kaka, SCCC, and Faith are shrined up and ready to go again.
Yep, they just keep moving around as the pair.
Dogfights has so much pressure on him in this early game too. He's like, I gotta stop these ganks, I gotta protect my Tinker, I gotta stack. Like, he has to protect his Terrorblade too. There's so many things that he needs to do.
It seems like the perfect timing as well for Newbie to do this. All the initial Observer Wards timed out. And IGV haven't even put down the new ones yet. There's only one new ward that's on the map and it's watching the front of the Roshan pit. And of course, where does Newbie go after they already successfully ganked up the mid lane? They head down to bottom lane. They look towards the Terrorblade again. So it was Dogfights and Super. Under the cover of smoke, would love to find a kill, but it's also the warding mission.
Can they even kill Sven with these two? There's no way, unless he's farming the left camp and they get Batrider involved. But Batrider, now he's fireflying over to the right side in case they can catch Sven, but Sven's pretty close to his shrine. That is just not going to be a potential kill.
Bottom lane behind the tower. Cicada on the run. The Frost going to slow him down. You even hold him in place with a Frost bite. And this is going from bad to worse for IG.
The supports just have no idea where to go right now. There are just too many fires to put out and not enough anything.
Not enough fire. Intel, I can't do anything still on that Batrider. Like, if there were some stacks there, he could have like farmed and taken from Newbie. Maybe then he could do some economical damage. But for the moment, it's a very safe place for Newbie to sit behind the tower. SC's got that Laguna Blade available, and Karka, again, moving into position to go for this quick little jump in on Paparazzi.
SCC also going for the Yules first, making a big deviation from the standard arcane bloodstone that we see. Yules is one of the best items for Tinker. You cannot blink after it. You can't really do anything from a Yules initiation onto Tinker if you actually get caught out by the Yules. So usually, to play around that, you just don't get caught out by Yules and use your blink positioning very, very well. But
you wanted the item for Sven? It's a Mask of Madness.
Mask of Madness is really good. I was considering that because there's not actually that much physical damage. You're only worried about Terrorblade, and you have Warcry for that. And he's the only source of physical damage on the team.
Oh.
And he's shut down pretty hard.
So he's going Mask of Madness into Echo Saber. That's a lot of attacks coming very quickly at IG. Not to mention his farm rate just goes through the roof.
I like the lifesteal so they can do Roche easily. They already have Avernus for Roche and combine that with a Mask of Madness and Lina damage. Ooh, it should be very easy.
Kaka's going to make a move right now. The kick actually dropping him down with a Frostbite. In July, can't run straight out of it. So Dogfights again with the kicks. Have to try and create more space, but Kaka stuns available. In July will back up. And KP will rotate himself towards the top lane, allowing Dven to head down to the bottom. And in fact, he's now going to start farming up the Radiant jungle. I suppose when you're in the neighborhood, you got an Observer Ward sitting in the lane, you feel pretty confident. There's no God Strength left, but he just war cries and approaches the lane. And what do you really do as a Terrorblade against this?
You hope your teammates don't get ganked. Smoke gank up from the top. Kaka and Faith.
The Observer Ward is actually... Then again, they don't see anything. The smoke is there.
Trying to avoid in July and go for the Tinker. Tinker's still pretty far away from his BOTs. Needs 800
Paparazzi. He's got a double damage, it doesn't really help out Tinker, and there's no committal just yet from the Lina.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Sven can kind of farm wherever he wants, I would say, until Batrider gets his Blink Dagger. And Batrider's Blink is still quite a bit of ways. They need a lot of heroes with farm. They need him with Blink Dagger, they need the Tinker with BOTs, and they need Terrorblade with, what, Lance into Manta? What we generally see, do you even want a Manta versus Sven? I guess you have to.
I don't know. Right now, I think, that stun barely missing from Kaka. So this is now the war of attrition. Like, Newbie have picked up a hand of Midas before the 10-minute mark over on KP. This Abaddon is just going to skyrocket in levels and farm. You're looking for U9, who's up to level 11 already. And in July, you can start this gank, but TP support into the shrine might be able to help. In fact, a storm bolt out from U9. There's your pick up, the double TPs. They're coming to the tier 2 tower, but with Warcry up, they just don't have any damage.
I mean, he didn't even need Warcry, really.
No, he didn't.
They just don't have any damage. Period.
And
no
only, one of those TPs completed. If both of them completed, maybe you'd see more maneuvering from Newbie to the bottom lane, but instead they're pressuring the top tier 1. So it's tier 1 for tier 1. You expect Terrorblade to do a push like this. So
tower, this tower goal will push Tinker into BOT territories though. So this is what they need to start to get the ball rolling for them. Get some kills on the map, push out some lanes so they can farm up a little bit more. And it's going to be a tough road for them, and looks like KP does not want to give this tower for free, but all he has is a puny Midas.
Yeah, this is a delay kind of game. At least he can drag the creep wave back with Mistcall. The fortification will protect the tower for now. And you still got that pressure being applied on top lane. So it's not just a straight tower trade, but IG, they're looking for more. So they TP in dogfights, rolling ball to forward. He doesn't connect on SC, so instead it's a stun the other way. Kaka focuses on dogfights, SC doesn't have enough mana for his ultimate, so he can't just Laguna Blade to find the kill. They'll hold him in position with the lasso, and they won't pump around to get that kill, and they will be able to do so. 350 gold going into that Tinker, bring him closer towards that Blink Dagger after having BTs.
Do you think he's going to get the minus 30 second respawn talent?
Felina?
Yeah.
I don't know.
After that, maybe. But do you want that? Yeah, most of them. The only one who hasn't been doing it is Sumail.
Yeah. But it just depends on the exact build. Like, going in for the Yule Scepter earlier may change his mind on it.
They see Sakata. Kaka needs to call some...
The CM's on the way.
Cavalry in.
And, like, Sakata ran the wrong way for this. Because Kaka can start the stun, Faith can rotate in, and if he wants to, he can just let it go as well. And in fact, that's exactly what he does. The stun will come into effect, but Super's in the middle of this as well. He can't get outside the Wukong Commander. Maybe he can. With a kick there, he's just able to run out of the rim of it. With the Monkey King going down. It's U9 who's the man to find the kill, and he's got enough to finish up his Echo Saber as well. So you bring that to the next engagement.
Neutral kick, Kaka.
What, really?
Yeah.
He actually got denied during that?
Yeah. I don't know what killed him, because they don't have high-level missiles coming out from Tinker. He actually is level 3 right now, but I don't think they had vision up there. But yeah, it was indeed a neutral creep.
So the only person who got a kill out of that was SC. Neutral creep kills Kaka, and U9 killed Sakata. All right, cool. Can IG not get a break?
Doesn't seem like it. Does not seem like it just yet. How's net worth looking? Terrorblade, he's getting there. Tinker's getting there as well. Sven is just free farming though. Not a care in the world.
Mm-hmm. He's kind of feeling like an alchemist in this game. Just sitting there farming up, staying ahead of everybody else.
But I think you're okay with ignoring a Sven. You're not okay with ignoring an alchemist.
Yep. But once that blink, so he's going blink BKB as U9's next primary items. A lot of prep work being applied up on top lane. Dogfights, however, walking underneath the Dire Observer was not going to help, because now they know either he's on a warning mission or he's on a ganking mission. And with the jump forward, they know dogfights, it was a warning mission. So the initial stun, follow up, KP's going to be in the neighborhood. A quick kick, actually clipping the Monkey King.
That was a really nice play. That was his only way to escape, because or else Kaka would have just tried to move around to the south side to block his rolling boulder.
They're still going to lose the sentry ward there, the observer ward. Yeah. And they really needed to keep some level of vision inside the newbie jungle. Their other observers are stuck on bottom lane.
They should actually... It's pretty nice to be able to smoke and place observer wards. I think if you're very desperate for vision, you can do that, but it seems like they want to prioritize perhaps the smokes on the Batrider so they can get kills on anyone. But with the respawn timer on Lina, like, do you really want to smoke ink her? Sven has been in pretty good positions. So they will go for smoke. Where to?
Well, the one position they have vision of is the Observer Ward.
She's level 10 with respawn time down. She's going to respawn in like 5 seconds.
There's your blink. Able to hit the lasso. Creep in the neighborhood. Now going to be removed, and so was the Lina. So, yep, dead for 5 seconds.
Can they transition this into a push? There is a creep wave meeting at the mid tower, so that is perfect timing from them.
But here comes Nubi. Like, your lasso is down. Kaka will give you the vision. Dogfeisty, just try and clear off the tree line. Right now, he has no idea. So SC drops the stun and the Laguna Blade. The follow-up's on clipping the Terra Blade, and Crystal Maiden just lets the ulti go, combining it up with the Wukong Command. Invictus Gaming, they thought it could be a time to push the Tier 1 tower, and really, it was just a time to die.
So much for transitioning a smoke ink to a tower kill. So much for that.
And then they start losing the vision too. So there goes another Observer Ward down the drain. Like, Nubi have been actually really lucky with their Observer Wards. The Sentry Wards, which IG placed to try and track them down, both of them missed inside the Radiant Jungle. Mm-hmm. But Tinker does have his Blink Dagger up and running, so a lot more maneuverable. Paparazzi can start creating a lot more space, but at the same time, there's also the Blink Dagger over on Sven. Monkey King jumps in, able to connect the stun! Did they know we're still there? Yep, they do. They definitely do now. Kaka is running outside the March of the Machines. So pick up, KP, ultimate just came back off cooldown again, so he'll be able to trigger that one. Try to turn in and try and fight into dogfights. The stuns are available from SC as well as Kaka. But KP just aphotic shields and walks away.
He was trying to get the Curse of Avernus onto the Tinker, but was not able to stop him or his Blink Dagger. Tinker actually had Ags on Quick Wipe before the Aether Lens. And that's fairly unusual, I would say. I think the Aether Lens is not only important for casting laser, but it's also really important to be able to blink further, which I think is very, very important when you're trying to like dodge all these like blink stuns, like Boundless Strike, Lina, Light Strike Array, Dragon Slave, Yules. Like, all these things clipping you is going to be really bad for you in a team fight, and not to mention a Monkey King ulti. So I think having the Aether Lens is pretty important, but I think he's viewing it like, I need damage right now because Terra Blade is underfarmed and I'm pretty much the only way to deal with the Sven, because Sven is going to be, is going to have a lot of armor because of Warcry, and he can't, he's not going to die to the Terra Blade unless he gets sundered off, but that's unreliable, especially when Lotuses start coming out.
Mm-hmm.
Lotus is a really great item here. Good against Lasso, good against Lift, good against Sunder, and great against Tinker.
Do you actually prioritize it on the Monkey King over getting something like the Basha?
I think Monkey King always gets better. I think for a Crystal Maiden, maybe over like Glimmer Cape, I think you could potentially see value out of that. Although Glimmer, I think, is still really good too.
Scepter up, and in July hits the ground very hard. Even Laguna Blade being committed just put the icing on the cake.
Yeah, and God Strength. Unnecessary roughness.
Honestly, he's just doing because he understands now they can push the bottom lane. That tier 2 tower, Nubi's been chipping away, trying to get closer and closer towards the tower, but with God Strength up, Moon 9 doesn't take much, and he's body blocking the wave with the fake tree. Moon 9 will still clear it up. But one of these trees is not like the other. One of these trees is a massive stick. Dogfights, rolling ball to fall, but Moon 9. Still very quick with the Blink Dagger. More support is coming in the form of the Batrider, and they get the consolation prize. There's the box of chocolate to go with the Wheel of Fortune game. Faith will fall.
No, CM. No.
Why? It didn't have to be this way. She had an entire life in front of her. She's not like a sister. She can't come back to life again so quickly.
She's dead. Dead for a while.
And now Kaka can push the lane. Like, you know, IG thought, like, yeah, we're fine. We can move up towards the top lane. Maybe we can look at the last tier 1 tower of there of Nubis to get rid of it.
Oh, he already has Midas on Monkey King? Oh, no. That's really bad.
All right, so maybe he can get both Lotus Orb as well as Basha.
I think he just buys items for himself. I think the CM, like, maybe Glimmer Lotus, potentially, or Abba. I don't know. Abbas haven't really been building it that often unless they get Orchided, but even then, they prefer Manta over it, so I don't know. I still think Lotus is pretty good this game, but I'm not sure if it takes priority over any of the normal items that they pick up.
Here comes that push on top lane. IGV does love to ride the momentum of this a little bit harder than they did on the bottom, so just a quick push into the Tier 1 tower, potentially looking to the Tier 2 tower.
Don't even need a meta. 8 intel. I remember watching OP. He actually very often takes his defensive talents, like armor and health, as opposed to the armor and the cast range. Armor and spell lamp, and then I almost always see people take the cast range. Mm-hmm. 75 is not that much compared to Aether, but
so is IGV. Okay, IGV will keep going. The bottom tier 3 tower is taking a little bit of chip damage, but the creep wave is obviously just going to push straight back out again, and now you can be a metamorphosis. They really want this tier 2 tower, and it's up to Nubi to decide if they want to try and fight it as well. So a photic shield stolen by the Rubick, that's going to be very useful, but SC moving in, so is KP, trying to take that damage. He has the ultimate available. But he doesn't have as many friends as you'd think. Now the rest of Nubi is starting to come back up to the top lane. The only one who's not there is Ven, and he's going back to farm. They'll let the tier 2 tower fall, so if IGV want to keep the push going to tier 3 tower, Nubi will be happy to oblige them with a fight. Or maybe they find the Monkey King, the jump forward Kaka, able to get the stun off and then start the retreat. The Yule Scepter kept the Batrider out, and now you go into the Wukong Command around the tier 2 tower. This will definitely allow for a denial at least, with the rockets and the march of the machines down. Nubi have to be careful about fighting, but now U9 will join the engagement. So Wukong Command down, KP's ulti's triggered as well. But the tier 2 tower is lost. There's nothing more for IGV to fight for here.
Tree on tree action. Looks like Tinker and Batrider have that edge. Monkey King has been, Kaka's been pretty good about jumping down before he gets stunned. I even remember seeing him earlier in the mid lane when Lina was trying to light strike a Ray, a hero, and he jumped down right before. They have clearly played this slash grin with it a lot before, as from what it seems like from their teamwork. Something I like what teams do against Terrorblade is they like feign a defense at the T1. You like show one hero and then they're like, oh crap, they're going to defend. And then you pot the meta early because you expect the fight to happen. And then you actually just waste like half the duration of the meta because of one hero showing. This probably isn't worth it versus a Batrider, but if you're Abu or something, potentially it is something that you can do to limit IGV's push threat. Because they were able to secure two towers off of that. Meta is going to be down for this engagement.
Good observable placement as well from Kaka. He bounded up on top of the tree line so they know they can take Roshan and then potentially turn into the fight. In July, on the run out, Kaka will fall down. So he's currently trapped inside the trees and he cannot get back out again. SC will have to cut him a path.
So Radiant Youth can right on top of the Roche Pit, which is actually not a bad idea versus Monkey King, because normally Monkey King's right around the...
on the trees, on the outside.
Trees, so he'll still hit with it red with the scan. So that's... you know, normally like, why would you do that? Why would you skin there? But it's very reasonable versus Monkey King, because if you expect to fight, bam, drop your ult, and you're forced to fight into Wukong's command inside the Roach Pit. That is a recipe for disaster.
But IGV at least avoid that disaster for now. But Nubi, the Aegis is immortal in hand.
I think Sven's ready to fight.
You think he is?
He
now?
Is ready to fight. He has BKB. You don't buy BKB unless you're ready to fight or you're about to lose.
Well,
it's one of those two.
Well, if you're ready to fight, then SC needs to be ready to dish out the damage. Obviously, Zven's going to be able to do a decent amount of damage himself, but if you're going high ground, a lot more pressure is on this Lina. She does have that level 2 talent up now and approaching her Bloodstone.
I'm not actually sure who your tower hitter is. Sven is...
should it not be SC?
Yeah, but he doesn't do that much damage and he's hitting up high ground and they have an ABBA, so like normally Sven wouldn't be a good tower hitter, but because you have ABBA perhaps, maybe you want ABBA actually being out in front so he gets lassoed. I'm not particularly sure how they go. Maybe they can just have all three hitting it. Why not?
Yeah.
That's a pretty good defensive formation if you have all three, because then ABBA's close enough to shield the Sven.
And then Crystal Maid and the Monkey King can play the back line.
Yep. And then you have Curse of Avernus on the tower for additional damage. It's all pretty good. Or they could just play the farm game because they have Midas Radiance on ABBA and tons of items on Sven and tons of items on Lina. All three of those on top of the net worth chart. So 225 health, a little mix of armor.
Well, there's Terrorblade's BKB before the fight begins. That'll be nice for him.
Yep.
A lot of that magical damage that Nubi want to be pumping out no longer available against the Terrorblade.
And the Ags. Axe is up on Tinker.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see those 5-man lasers and 4-man rockets.
Blind them all. Keep the bottom lane pressure down as well. So Nubi, if they do go for this push, remember that they are going to be on a clock to achieve it. While Tinker is keeping the side lanes pressure down. Okay, this is a good way to start it. Wukong Command straight up in the Terrorblade. BKB or not, it's only useful if you can push the damn button. The tier 2 tower gets evaporated as well. I think it lasted longer than Sakatan.
Dogfight's tried. He was very quick at that boulder smash, but he just died before the boulder traveled like 1,000 range. That was rough. they were taking no chances too. Sven, you know, maybe sometimes you don't pop the BKB if you expect to blow Laguna on them, but they're like, ah, nope, I do not want him to Sunder at all.
Mm-hmm. The Blink Dagger on the Earth Spirit. Now, at least that's one way you can close the distance a little quicker, but you got 2 minutes left on the Aegis for Newbie. I think we're looking at a high ground push, but they can definitely look to go down the mid. Sven gets bigger, so his level 20 is going to be the 15% evasion as his choice.
Actually just wants to tank up. Normally you see attack speed, but I guess with Echo, attack speed loses a little bit of value. And he has mask, actually, so.
He changed his mind, too. He's going for Lincoln Sphere after he was looking at the Crystallis.
Lincoln Sphere with BKB. Can't get Thundered, can't get Lassoed, although a Spell Steal, I suppose, could break it.
Super's looking for the ward, but it's Newbie with Tinker Ward's up.
Yeah,
very clear vision over the trees on the top lane.
They are not scared of Tinker at all.
Nope.
I wonder if Paparazzi is going to actually permanently switch to the mid lane. Two games in a row with heroes that aren't Invoker.
Yeah.
Might be the start of a trend.
Maybe. Maybe they just feel more comfortable with this. It seems very odd, though, to do it. Like, and you come this far through the tournament, and then you switch it when you reach the top four.
I think if they were versus a team that they hadn't played before or they had done well against, I don't think they would have changed. But because they did get crushed by Newbie earlier, I think they're like, you know, why not? We lost against them with our normal strat. Let's just try something else, see if it works.
Yeah. Well, the push is coming onto that tier 2 town, as we said. So with the insurance that is the Aegis, the tier 2 tower is quite easily killed off. SE doing majority of the damage. And there is another frontliner. A Blade Mail was the next item up from KPS coming on the courier at the moment. So you have Blade Mail from him. You've got Sven with all of his survivability. I'm not certain where IG dish out the damage. I'm not even sure Tinker is able to survive if KP continues to sit inside March of the Machines with the Blade Mail turned on.
He has a lot of HP. He went for the HP talent, so he, you know, kind of barely survivable. 1700
Smart Spark. That bloody monkey. always there to spoil.
I do like how Kaka's been playing, though. He's, you know, just been super annoying. Yeah. He actually has Midas and Shadowblade now.
And now we'll build into the Basher.
Oh, man.
I suppose that's the easier way to stay, like, say, undetected, but still inside the command.
Oh, yeah, it's one of the best ways. With Echo, you can actually get a lot of solo kills. It's also very good for trying to scout out the Tinker. Yeah, that was a
Newbie sense their regards. That Ruby did not stand a chance. I suppose Laguna Blade cooldown is nice and low anyway. He's not that concerned. And, well, in July, you just tried to Firefly and blink in the lasso underneath the Tinker Ward. At least the stunts from Dogfights will allow some space, but they know exactly where they're TPing out. Kaka will find them. He has no bash to lend. So the escape will be real.
Oof.
But at the same time, I'm wondering if IG know there was an Observer Ward or if they just thought they got completely outplayed by SC.
I'm not sure which one they think. Actually.
That Yules was very quick. And SC now buys up his Blink Dagger. So now you got Blink Yule's initiation with 14 Bloodstone charges from the Lina. Good positioning. That's one way you can just take the high ground. Who cares about putting the tanks on the front lines? Just kill them. Kill them and go. Same thing happening again up on top lane. Super underneath the ward. He came out here with 2 sentry wards. He knew exactly what he was trying to do. He's trying to get rid of that vision, but KP and Kaka, they are on the prowl. They're on the hunt.
That's scary how fast these supports die. If they're like inside Monkey King ult, they just have no chance of surviving. And it's going to be a problem if it's just Tinker able to output a lot of damage here. Terrorblade Illusions still aren't strong enough to stand up against Lina, let alone a Sven and a Lina.
Mm-hmm.
And Sven is very rapidly approaching max slots.
Now he's got that Lincoln Sphere up and running. He can still switch out the Mask of Madness. And you can see his next item. So Bloodthorn is U9's next port of call.
Yeah, now you have to start thinking about how you're going to start saving the Terrorblade. I guess he has BKB now, but no damage? That's rough. Damage is a severe issue, but that's where Tinker High Ground Hole comes in with the Axe. One of the best high ground defenses there is.
Okay, do you set the courier up or do you try and send yourself? He wants the ultimate orb. Okay, Sentry Ward, Super can pick him up, but just run away, U9! Okay! Newbie want this to be done. The bottom tier 2 tower, however, it is where KP is holding them back.
You would have just died on the Echo Saber hit. Bloodstone charge is a Bloodstone charge, though.
Definitely shows the pace. Okay, dogfights. Rolling boulder over, but there's friends here. SCTP'd in. And dogfights.
Nice
it's meant
try.
To be Paparazzi who runs for the open arms of SC for a hug.
Not the kind of hug that you...
No. That's the hug that burns.
And I think they're actually trying to start... They want to push high ground pretty soon. Abba is actually building a hood, so he's not going for any more, you know, farming items slash team fight items. Pipe is up. Let's break high ground item against the Tinker. So he can actually just run into March. It's also really good with Blade Mode. Just like, oh yeah, I don't care about March. I'm not going to take any damage, and I'm going to reflect a ton back to the Tinker.
Yep. So then you get the Laguna Blade as well, upgrade. So Aghanim Scepter is the port of call for Lina. He got so much to deal with everything that IG offers.
Yeah, Terror Blade, BKB, not very useful versus Axe Lina. That's going to be half his HP.
Especially if he's trying to run through the command now. The Basher is done on the Monkey King as well. All these things are adding up.
Yep. Still, they have to be able to get to the Tinker, though. That is, that's a big issue. How do you actually get to the Tinker? You have to
just run at him?
You have to see him. How do you actually see him in the base?
That's a good question.
You could, like, blink Yulzin with Alina, but you need a BKB on her to be able to do that. Monkey King can't get in there. You don't want to be, like, that deep. You want to be, you know, kind of chilling far back.
Oh, they see dogfights. Again, it's the blink. Yulz. Silence will be there onto the Alina, but it won't really matter. And just happy to expend all of their abilities. And top lane again, Tinker forcing in the top lane. So
this Aegis could be the last straw for IG Vitality. They have to do something about this soon. Looks like they just are not able to contest rush at all. So split push so that they can't get to your base or have a miraculous high ground defense with Tinker.
Split push is it, man. There's no one defending that top tower. IG has to know what's going on, but there's nothing they can do to stop it.
It's a Rubick and a Batrider, though.
I'm not saying it's going to be easy, but beating Newbie was never meant to be easy.
Pipe complete. I think it's time.
Oh, boy. So at least they got one third of the top tier 3 tower of Newbies down.
I'm wondering if they can like creep skip at all from IGV to try and stall out this Aegis. You definitely do not want them pushing high ground with the Aegis.
They're hunting themselves. All right, well, we could do Tinker Wards too. Blink Lasso. it's KP with an Aegis.
Yeah. That's a no-go.
TP. Yeah, okay. The plan has a serious fault in it. The fault is we attempted it.
We're done here. Go farm, guys.
Well, that's a nice one. The blink to the left side of the trees. As, rolling boulder four. They try and find the Monkey King. But Kaka, the sentry was down for himself. And at the moment, it's Kaka on the world. He can stay inside the Wukong command. Dogfights now walks in. He's losing so much life walking into it. He's almost dead on 58 HP. He has to blink away. KP running forward. Super will stay in the tree lines. And now Super, they find him. Just the jumping by. And SC casually looks to the side. Extends the hand, and bada bing, bada bing.
That was balanced. You almost kill someone while you're invis. You're just doing nothing. You're just standing there.
Yep.
You did have to press R though.
Yeah. Hey, difficult man. It's almost like you're crapping on Zeus players.
Gotta press R. I mean, Abba doesn't even have to press R, so it's a step up from that.
Yep.
Nice.
Well, that tier 3 tower taking a hell of a lot of damage. They still have the Aegis, so they still have their front runner. Even though there's not a lot of mana left on KP.
They're actually out of there.
Interesting. Well,
KP, I guess, can shrine up after this, but they don't have that much time left. It's 3 minutes. They're going to shrine. They're going to push out the lane. So maybe 1.5 once they actually get to the T3s.
They want to finish KP's Octarine before they push?
That's a lot of GPM. That's like 1,000 GPM right now to get there.
I think he's okay with that. He's got the entire bottom lane to himself. And it's Invictus Gaming who are the ones coming out. Now, they're smirked up when they ran underneath that Dire Observer Ward. Tinker's the only one that's really being revealed.
Sven's a little bit vulnerable. He's the... They see him with the Observer Ward right now, but...
What do you do, man? Like, your Batrider has to get the Blink Blast. Sorry, that's the only way that works.
Yep.
But what has Batrider got? He needs his own four star.
Oh, what a regeneration
to drag back this Ven, but he actually has to use the four star to trigger the Lincoln Spear to then get the lasso.
And they have to make sure that no one's around him too. That's just a tall order.
A lot of problems.
With the regen rune on Abba though, they should be able to push with a healthy time left on the Aegis. Looks like 2 minutes left. And they approach the T3s and all three lanes are pushed out.
Yep.
That is a win.
It is. As if they can get in, remember the most amount of damage they did was up on the top lane before, not the bottom.
He's running with blade mail though.
Yep.
Okay, now one mid lane wave is dead. They only have their bottom creep wave surviving, but Paparazzi's already there to kill that wave.
Yep. Tinker, delay. You have to buy more time. I'm not exactly certain for what.
For newbie to throw.
That's really what actually has to have happen.
They just have to go in too deep close to the drive.
Like something needs to screw up with like Batrider getting the greatest drag of his life and dogfights just keeping him out with a great kick or Marshall Machines. Like that's the only way. You're gonna split newbie up, but how do you do this when this is your attack? It's flying V from newbie, jumping inside the base, you pick up the bat, you throw him around, but your issue is that blade mount. So much damage on Paparazzi, so he's having to fight underneath his own shrine. It's the only way he keeps the mana up. Akaka, now the command is done. The lasso, it's dragging back this Ven in range of the mid tower as well. So U9 copping a lot, especially when it's the Terrorblade standing his ground. He'll do the work, and Munga King has to get out of here. Same with KP, but Aegis the Immortal, well, actually, that ain't gonna trigger. But you do bring down this Ven. The price you pay is your top melee racks.
He got his Lincoln's pop before he bought his BKB, and then July saw that opportunity, grabbed them in right next to the shrine, and it was impossible for them to save him. I think Abba had a shield down at that point too. He wasn't able to shield the lasso off, it seems like. Overall, I am a little bit surprised that they gave the, like, you generally get the Aegis to your tower hitter, right? But they were hitting tower with both the Abba and the Sven. Ideally, the Abba can keep the Sven safe, so you don't actually need the Aegis on the Sven, but that was not able to happen. It just was not a perfectly coordinated fight from them.
Is there an item that Sven would actually want to give up? Like, for the Aegis? Maybe that was the other thing, where KP had the item slot.
You get Lotus from your supports, is generally what you do. You're like, there's nothing Batrider can do about Lotus or one of them. Like, you can't last with that, period. So
I don't see anyone building it yet. No quick buys. Looks like Monkey King building
BKB.
For himself. Yeah, it would just have to be the Crystal Maiden, I suppose, or the Abba himself. But it looks like he is going Octarine and almost has it.
Yeah. He bought the Soul Booster directly after the top fight.
They have Hex on Tinker now, too. They definitely need a Lotus.
Yep. But maybe not itemizing for it.
Yeah.
For now, it just needs to be itemizing for our frontline tanks. We bring down the towers. That's the goal.
Yeah, I think last fight they could have just had Abba hit the tower too. I don't know if they would have gotten the racks that way, but it is, you know, you always want to think, okay, what went wrong last time? What can we do next time to make this fight go a lot smoother and not lose our highest net worth hero? I presume he was
at that time.
Highest before that.
It would have been close. Like the top three right now, all sitting around that 21 to 23,000, and all of them belong to newbie. And the overall advantage, all right. Yeah, that's a deep pit that IG need to climb their way out of. Even the experience, it hit 50,000 in favor of newbie. This is going to start to cap up, however. Like you'll hit level 25 on almost everyone, especially the cores.
They actually are capped out. SECC is soft six slotted, I suppose. So like you can trade out your Aether Lens for something, but it's not that great just because the range on Aether is great and the Sven, soft cap too, I suppose. You can get like Bloodthorn perhaps. Abba, trade out your Midas for something.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe like a Scepter if you're worried about your Sven.
Bottom lane, goodbye Tinker. The Observe Ward did the work. SC was waiting for him.
Oh god, now a little Bloodstone charge. Oh, he doesn't have Bloodstone, that's right. That's a full respawn. He didn't have buyback, he just bought Hex.
Yeah, he's down for a full minute. If newbie have cottoned onto this fact, then they can push in through bottom. With no Tinker, with no wave here. Injuli almost has to Firefly down the wave when it arrives. Metamorphosis will probably have to be triggered, and the Observe Ward inside the base, yeah, that ain't gonna last, but SC takes the opportunity. Blink, Yule Scepter, a quick counter yield, however, creating space for Injuli, and the commander's down. try and create a little bit more space. No one from IG has caught sight of this, but it's still allowing Newbie to beat into the tier 3 tower. Fortification will slow this attack, but it's only slowing him for a little bit longer. Newbie, they've broken the tier 3 tower. They're breaking the base. But Melee Rakt is still target number one until SC in straight away takes out the Rubick. Both of them do not have buyback, and that one pickoff on the Tinker is probably going to spell megas in favor of Newbie.
So much for no field.
Yeah, has no effect on fights. A great silence kick on the back line. And maybe now the Terrorblade, under the power of his BKB, tries to stand his ground. Mana Style up, manning up against Kaka. It's all up to Sakata. Can he do the work? He's able to do it with a Sunder, but the Sun's there from U9 combining with KP. Three down. Buyback is available for Terrorblade. Without his Metamorphosis, maybe not so powerful, but Tinker also on the front lines. Laser it up, they need these kills. You Hex up on one, but SC back to the front lines. Paparazzi, defensive fuels, he needs to blink out this one, but he can't do it. The stun is there, he's still down. A full minute and GG is called. Newbie have done it. They will advance forward and face up against the other Invictus Gaming squad in that lower bracket final to see who will represent China in the grand final against OG.
Perhaps, as you mentioned, they maybe shouldn't have swapped.